I wanted to tell you guys about my awesome deck that totally works. So basically, yeah, this deck is just like my ongoing thing. And what I like about it is that, you know, you start with Ant-Man, you do something like Maximus, Maxer Mold, then you have Mobius kind of for protection. Super Skrull if they're doing like Hella Tribunal, which can often be the case. And then it's fun to do Omega Red and Onslaught on the same lane, so you get a bunch more power at your other locations. Almost every card in the deck is ongoing, so Spectrum can be helpful, or Claw is good for getting into unreachable locations. So I feel like so far this has been working, and I've thoroughly been enjoying Ronin's new ability that he actually shows in your hand how big he's going to be. And Maximus and Master Mold really help out with Ronin, so I think it's cool. I think it's so far so good, so we're going to knock on wood and give this a try in Proving Grounds, or I guess we're in Silver. What's the inspiration for this deck? I think my Mobius is really cute, and I also have noticed, okay, there's multiple inspirations here, which is that, you know, I really like my Master Mold variant. I like this Mobius variant. I've been seeing more people using Ronin, and it looks fun. I also really like the Spectrum variant. Same thing with Omega Red. It's been looking fun. So I guess I kind of just put a bunch of ongoing cards together that I feel like I don't personally use often. I guess aside from Iron Man and kind of Onslaught, I don't use many of these cards much. And so I called it, you know, Ongoing Hell, because, I mean, it actually has been working fairly well. Bolt's diet, she eats crunchy food, she has a break for her jaw, eating it, hence the retainer. Yeah, that too. Never seen that before. Oh, it's happened to me at least like 3 times. It's a special moment where you tie every single lane completely. Like, yeah. This is a little scary because I need Master Mold badly. I'm not going to be able to play on Morag, like, at all. Schnirp, is the Otani gambling thing a big deal where you live? I have no idea what that means. I don't know anything about that. So I guess the answer would be no. Yeah, what is Otani? I have no idea. What is that? Oh, it's a person? Oh, it has something to do with baseball? Yeah, sorry, I don't know anything about that. Wait, did I just play nothing? No, I played something. The Dodgers just signed Shohei Ohtani for like $500 million. I'm sending this because it's a maybe. Versus interpreter borrowed money from Ohtani and paid millions in gambling losses, but now it's theft, and everyone's like, his English interpreter gambled like $5 million and the money was stolen from the baseball player. Oh. Yeah, no, I may be guilty of... I can't believe I just won on left with one. Victory. Probably be arranged. Classy, yes. Well, I think I'm... I mean, no. I will not do that, because it's always Ultron. Drinking chocolate milk out of a wine glass with a bendy straw. What's the worst that would happen if you got a copyright against you? No, I mean, it would be fine. I'm just, I guess the thing is, it's a bigger deal on YouTube, and I'm trying to, you know, create YouTube content with my videos. So, I just am trying to be
friendly neighborhood like, Spider-Man
specific
here.
About it. Does copyright now count on Twitch VODs? It always has. It always has. Or you mean, does it not count on Twitch VODs? No, it does. That's why people do like what I'm doing, which is technically against the rules, where I've split the audio tracks. So, like what you hear in the VOD, you do not hear the background music I'm playing. You can still get in trouble for that. Okay, I know. No. Yeah, I mean, technically, Lo-Fi Girl is like allowed, but the reason I'm splitting it is because when I went onto YouTube and I had Lo-Fi Girl in the background, it says the copyright holder allows this music to be used in videos, which may not always be the case because I don't own the copyright. It's Lo-Fi Girl, so currently they allow it, but that can change any time. So that's like, you know, a little bit more precarious, so that's why I've been splitting it. But yeah, so they don't auto delete the songs, they just mute the entire video. It would be really cool if they could just delete the songs, but they don't. They mute everything. Okay, so we'll get a random 6-cost card, but we'll do that as our second thing. We'll do Onslaught to make everything huge, and then do Ant-Man. This is gonna go great. I'm really excited. But yeah, no, technically Lo-Fi Girl's allowed because it's not allowed on YouTube. Doom, oh my gosh, it's Pixel all. Doctor Doom. And then they get Spectrum? Someone streaming with actual music, their VODs are useless. Right. Hand. Easy! Look at this. Victor. Yeah, what are you guys talking about? This must be some sports related thing. A notorious American football play from a National Football League game played on Thanksgiving in 2012. From the home crowd of over 79,000 fans, at MetLife Stadium and a primetime television audience of over 20 million, Jets quarterback Mark Sanchez collided with the butt of his teammate. Oh, you know what? I think I remember this. Causing a fumble, which was recovered by the Patriots safety Steve Gregory in return for a touchdown. The play was the centerpiece of a disastrous sequence of the second quarter, wherein the Jets lost 3 fumbles and the Patriots scored 3 touchdowns in the span of 52 seconds of game time. Oh, man. That's wild. Okay, I have this debris. I'm thinking I probably shouldn't play it. But I'm going to. Okay. Yeah, that's funny. I should watch the NBA and that's about it. Yeah, I feel like if I had to watch any type of sports, I would watch basketball. I find it, you know, interesting to watch. Other sports, I just get really bored. My family is from Boston. Yeah. No, even when I lived in Boston, I was just like, that was before I lived in Pittsburgh, and in Boston, I was just like, I think that was during the time when the Patriots, there was the thing where the ball was like deflated a little bit, and everyone's like, oh, they cheated. And, yeah, so I always just have a bad feeling about the Patriots, even though, again, I don't like follow sports.
I definitely need to
like makes her sleep only capturing football season.
Enough said, bub.
Quarter doesn't have a W in it. I don't have priority, so I don't know how this is supposed to go. There's nothing. I don't know. Sirius the Dynasty? Wait, yeah, what's it called, Jin? It's about
enough said.
Oh.
Bob.
Yeah, I misread that. Alright, so I guess they're not doing anything about mid. Why? Oh, I snapped already and they. They might have null. Patriots were the link of the NFL. What does that mean? They were a joke? What does that mean? I'm trying to think of what that's supposed to mean. I feel like they're not gonna have null. I don't know what you were trying to get me to say. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Victory.
Don't forget to like and subscribe, and check out my other videos too.